a dream come true. In memory of our dear father, Dr. Hishmatullah Farhumand, 1913 to 1995. In the middle of the 18th century, in Hamadan, Iran, a Jewish rabbi and hakim, which means a physician, by the name of Hakim Agha Jan, became a believer in a new faith, which was greatly persecuted and taught principles unheard of at the time. This young faith, which began in the year 1844, had two divine revelations, the Bab, which meant gate, and Baha'u'llah, which meant glory of God. The principles of this new faith were quite revolutionary for their time, and they included
the independent investigation of truth, the unity of mankind, the unity of religion, the harmony of religion and science, the elimination of all forms of prejudice, the equality of men and women.
In a tablet to the Hakim, Baha'u'llah prophesied that his descendants would share the new message of God to kings and rulers. In 1951, two of the great-grandchildren of Hakim Agha Jan closed their successful medical and dental practices in Tehran to go pioneering to Africa. The older brother, Dr. Manoocheher Farhumand, set up his medical practice in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. The second brother, Dr. Hishmatullah Farhumand, established a dental practice in Asmara and later on in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. Dr. Farhumand's practice was open to people of all race, colors, and religion. And this is an Italian patient that he had, Giovanna Mele. Dr. Farhumand was loved and respected by everybody, even including the royal family. When the Crown Prince of Ethiopia came to Virginia and he heard that the Farhumand family were there, he wanted to meet them, so he came to their home and they had a wonderful dinner together with the Crown Prince, his wife, and the family. Quite amazingly, four generations down, Baha'u'llah's promise to Hakim Agha Jan came true. Dr. Manoocheher Farhumand became the personal physician of President Nyerere and his family for years. And Dr. Hishmatullah Farhumand became the dentist of the imperial family of Ethiopia and all the ministers. In honor of our two heroes, our beautiful mother left Iran for Africa at the age of 22. And she was accompanied by our courageous dad. These are our two heroes. In 1950, Dr. Farhumand was happily married, had two beautiful children, a large and loving family, and a very successful dental practice in Tehran, Iran. They were a very happy family, very united, and having always a wonderful time. In 1950, the Guardian of the Baha'i Faith called for the believers to go pioneering all over the world.
These two brothers closed their successful medical and dental practices and went to Africa, one to Tanzania and the other to Ethiopia.
They left their physical family in Iran, but gained their spiritual family in Ethiopia.
The diversity in the human family should be the cause of love and harmony, as it is in music, where many different notes blend together in the making of a perfect chord. If you meet those of a different race and color from yourself, do not mistrust them and withdraw yourself. Think of them as different colored roses growing in the beautiful garden of humanity, and rejoice to be among them. God, the Almighty, has created all mankind from the dust of the earth. He has fashioned them all from the same elements. They are descended from the same race and live upon the same globe. He has created them to dwell beneath one heaven as members of the human family and his children. He has endowed them with equal susceptibilities. He maintains, protects, and is kind to all. He has made no distinction in mercies and graces among his children. With impartial love and wisdom, he has sent forth his prophets and divine teachings. His teachings are the means of establishing union and fellowship among mankind, and awakening love and kindness in human hearts. He proclaims the oneness of the kingdom of humanity. He rebukes those things which create differences and destroy harmony. He commends and praises every means that will conduce to the solidarity of the human race. The prophets of God have been inspired with the message of love and unity. Prejudices of all kinds, whether religious, racial, patriotic, or political, are destructive of divine foundations of man. All the warfare and bloodshed in human history have been the outcome of prejudice. This earth is one home and one native land. God has created mankind with equal endowment and the right to live upon the earth. As a city is the home of all its inhabitants, although each may have his individual place of residence therein. So the earth's surface is one wide native land or home for all races of humankind.
The result of our heroes.
The true Baha'i loves the children because Jesus said they are of the kingdom of heaven. A simple, pure heart is near to God. A child has no worldly ambitions. Know thou of a certainty that love is the secret of God's holy dispensation, the manifestation of the All-Merciful. Love is heaven's kindly light, the Holy Spirit's eternal breath that vivifieth the human soul. Love is the cause of God's revelation unto man, the vital bond inherent in accordance with the divine creation and the realities of things. Love is the one means that ensureth true felicity both in this world and the next. Love is the light that guideth in darkness, the living link that uniteth God with man, that assureth the progress of every illuminated soul. Love is the most great law that ruleth this mighty and heavenly cycle, the unique power that bindeth together the divers elements of this material world. Love revealeth with unfailing and limitless power the mysteries latent in the universe. Love is the spirit of life unto the adorned body of mankind, the establisher of true civilization in this mortal world, and the shedder of imperishable glory upon every high-aiming race and nation.
O my Lord, I am a child of tender years. Nourish me from the breast of thy mercy, train me in the bosom of thy love. Educate me in the school of thy guidance, and develop me under the shadow of thy bounty. Deliver me from the darkness, make me a brilliant light. Free me from unhappiness, make me a flower of thy rose garden. Suffer me to become the servant of thy threshold, and confer upon me the disposition and thy nature of thy righteous one. Make me a cause of bounty to the human world, and crown my head with the diadem of eternal life. Verily, thou art the powerful, the mighty, the seer, the hearer.
Abdu'l-Bahá laid great stress on education. He said, "The girl's education is of more importance today than the boy's, for she is the mother of the future race. It is the duty of all to look after the children. Those without children should, if possible, make themselves responsible for the education of a child." A father and mother endure the greatest troubles and hardships for their children. And often when the children have reached the age of maturity, the parents pass on to the other world. Rarely does it happen that a father and a mother in this world see the reward of the care and trouble they have undergone for their children. Therefore, children in return for this care and trouble must show forth charity and beneficence, and must implore pardon and forgiveness for their parents. So you ought, in return for the loving kindness shown you by your father, to give to the poor for his sake, with greatest submission and humility, implore pardon and remission of his sins, and ask for the supreme mercy.
Assure Farhomand highly meritorious service. Shoghi, 1956.